गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, साई राम। वेलकम टू पार्ट 4 ऑफ हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 4 रिविजन सेशन, दैट इज द मुगल एम्पायर। सो चिल्ड्रन, लास्ट टाइम वी सॉ दैट जब्त वॉज द रेवेन्यू सिस्टम अंडर विच ईच प्रोविंस वॉज डिवाइडेड इंटू रेवेन्यू सर्कल्स विद इट्स ओन स्केड्यूल ऑफ रेवेन्यू रेट्स फॉर इंडिविजुअल क्रॉप्स। We also saw how Akbar's revenue minister Todarmal carried out careful survey of crop yields for a 10-year period. On the basis of this data, tax was fixed for each crop in cash. We saw the interesting fact during Aurangzeb's reign that the number of Mansabdars increased to 79. So as a result of this, they had to wait for a long time before they received a jagir. Not only that, actual revenue collected from jagir was often less than the granted sum. And as a result of this, jagirdars and mansabdars started to collect as much revenue as possible. Aurangzeb was unable to control this and thus peasantry suffered. Now let us move on to the next topic, that is a closer look at Akbar's policies. Now children, before we move ahead, as usual I want you all to be ready with your notepad and pen so that you can write down any important points that you feel like. After completion of one particular topic, I will be taking a small Q&A session, that is question and answer session. Okay, so let us start. Okay, so children, now before we move on to take a closer look at Akbar's policies, let us understand a little about Akbarnama and N-E-Akbari. Okay. Akbar ordered one of his close friends and courtiers, Abu Fazl, to write a history of his reign. Abu Fazl, okay, wrote a 3-volume history of Akbar's reign, and he titled it as Akbarnama. The first volume dealt with Akbar's ancestors, and the second volume recorded the events during the Akbar's reign. The third volume is the Ain-e-Akbari, and it deals with Akbar's administration, household, army, the revenues, and the geography of his empire. It also provides rich details about the traditions and culture of the people living in India. The most interesting aspect about Ain-e-Akbari is its rich statistical details about things as diverse as crops, yields, prices, wages, and revenues. The broad features of administration were laid down by Akbar and was elaborately discussed by Abu Fazl in his book, The Akbarnama. Abu Fazl explained that the entire system, okay, or the entire empire was divided into provinces such as Subas, governed by Subadar, who carried out both political and military functions. Each province also had a financial officer or Diwan. Now, for the maintenance of peace and order in this province, The Subedar was supported by other officers, such as the military paymaster, that is Bakshi, the minister, the charitable patronage, that is Sadra, the military commander, that is Fauzdars, and the town police commander. Okay, now Akbar's nobles commanded large armies and had access to large amounts of revenue. So while they were loyal to the empire, functioned efficiently, but by the end of the 17th century, many nobles had built independent networks of their own. Their loyalties to the empire were weakened by their own self-interest. When Akbar was at Fatehpur Sikri, okay, he started discussions on religion with the Brahmanas or the priests who were Roman Catholics, Zoroastrians. Now these discussions took place in Ibadat Khana. He was interested in the religion, in the social customs of different people. Akbar's interaction with people of different faith made him realize that religious scholars who emphasized ritual and dogmas were often bygods. Now children, we have discussed the meaning of dogma and bygod in the explanation session. Very important things that you should be knowing. Dogma is a statement or an interpretation declared as authoritative with the expectations that it should be followed without a questioning. And bygod is an individual who is intolerant of other person's religious beliefs or culture. So, their teachings created division and disharmony amongst his subject. Okay, and what happened was this eventually led to the idea of Sul Equal or universal peace. So this idea of tolerance just did not discriminate between people of different religions in his realm, but it focused on a system of ethics, that is honesty, peace and justice. Abul Fazl helped Akbar in framing a vision of governance around this idea of Sul Equal. This principle of governance was followed by Jahangir and Shah Jahan also. So now let us start with the Q&A session. Okay, that is the question and answer session. Let us take the first question now. Write a note on Akbar's administrative policies. So when such question is asked, check for the marks allotted to the question. If it is a big answer, you need to include all the points. Okay, like Abul Fazl in his book Akbarnama, especially in the third volume named N.A. Akbari, gave a detailed description of Akbar's administration. You can start like this. Then you can say that in the book, Abul Fazl explained that the empire was divided into provinces known as Subas and governed by Subedars. The Subedar carried out both political and military functions. The Subedars carried out both political and military functions. And now each province also had a financial officer or Diwan. This was for the maintenance of peace and order in the province. Subedar was appointed and he was supported by several officers like the military paymaster, that is Bakshi, minister in charge of religious and charitable patronage, that is Sadr, then military commanders like Faujdars and town police commander like Kotwal. Akbar's nobles commanded huge armies and had access to large amounts of revenue. Akbar did not want to discriminate people of different religions, so he gave utmost importance to the idea of tolerance. He accepted the concept of universal peace or sulh e kul. So this is how you have to write, okay, in detail. Okay, now let me take one more question. Give an account of Akbarnama and Ain-e-Akbari. Now children, again for your information, let me tell you this. When you are asked a particular question, okay, always check the marks allotted to that particular question. For example, if you are given a question which carries 3 marks, you are expected to write at least 3 points. If it is for 2 marks, you are expected to write 2 points. So on and so forth. Okay. Now let me answer this for you. Abul Faizi, one of the Akbar's close friends and courtiers, wrote a 3-volume history of the reign of Akbar. It was titled as Akbarnama. The first volume speaks about Akbar's ancestors. The second volume recorded events of Akbar's reign. Ain-e-Akbari is the 3rd volume and it deals with Akbar's administration, household, army, the revenues and the geography of the empire. This book also provides details about the traditions and culture of the Indian people. It is rich in statistical details about things and diverse as crops, yields, prices, wages and revenues. So I hope children, you are clear with how to answer the questions, okay? Again repeating myself, check for the number of marks allotted, you know, for that particular question and then answer. So children, with this I end part 4 of revision session of history chapter 4 Mughal Empire. See you in the last video of this chapter. Till then, goodbye and keep learning.